So this woman here, she looks like she's Afro-Latina on this picture. This was another one here. Of course, you know, I want to go through all of these things because he had all these different, you know, things to say. He's changing his story. I want to show him different ones. So he said here, yes, I was at Cherry Hill Mall today. The iPhone crashed last night, and the closest Apple store within the Melbourne market today was in Jersey. As I was leaving the mall, I stopped by the kiosk to get incense and crystals. That non-African woman, simply the vendor, a supporter came by for a photo of a black male, prompting her to ask me who I was. I told her I was a popular psychologist in the black community. Narcissism. He said, I paid for my merchandise and went on with my life. You dusty, snow bunny loving beta males don't believe me. Then visit the mall and ask her personally. We exchanged phone numbers. I was dealing with food poisoning and I wasn't in the mood for all that anyway. So, he said, heaviest the head who wears the crown. He said, you were dealing with food poisoning, so you wasn't in the mood for all of that. So, are you saying that you would exchange numbers with her? Okay, so now let's get to a video. I want to build all this up while I start really talking. Let's go to the video. They actually went to the mall and spoke to the young lady. Let's roll that.
Here we are. We are at the infamous stand. I was seeing the video yesterday, okay? She's like, hello. So you see, one, it is right by the Bistro Bar, so relax, y'all. He was right here.
Wasn't at the food court. He was here. The Apple store is right there. He literally came in, and so he walked in, and he was in my incense, and our incense are handmade. They're fresh. We sell natural remedies, like essentials. We have crystals. I came up to him, talked to him.
Wait, so pause. You're the girl that was in the video.
Yeah, I am the girl.
And how did you know you were not a white girl? Show us where.
Yep.
Now, so people looking at that video, people could ask you, well, why you was all tee-hee-heeing with her for? Why did you have to tell her that you was this popular psychologist in the black community? Why did you have to tell her that? Why would you give her that information? It seems like you're trying to impress her, Umar. Seems like it. Because if you was really on that like you talk about online, on this chick, Umar. And people, that brother say, you know what, Umar, I ain't mad at you, man. I ain't mad at you at all. That brother saying that, right? But he's trying to defend, I ain't got to do this, man. Stop lying, bro. Stop lying, Umar. Your body language said that, you know, you want to holler at her, Umar. Stop lying, bro. Stop lying. You realize, listen, you put out four different posts speaking about an incident. If you was a G about it, the first post you put, you should have left it alone and speak about the freaking crap no more. But the more you kept speaking on it, Umar, the more you kept dropping videos, Umar, the more you kept dropping live streams, it makes you guilty. You don't know the game? If you had some sort of knowledge of public relations,
Phil, he's a narcissist. He's a narcissist. Narcissists don't...
Don't keep talking about the crap. Because that's when you're giving people more ammo to talk about your behind. You did that, not the girl. Then you tell the people, ask the girl something. They didn't ask the girl nothing. Only thing she just confirmed that you was there. She didn't say, nah, he didn't get my phone number. Nah, he wasn't talking to me. She didn't confirm anything, Umar. So that's an epic fail, too, sending somebody to go film that woman. If I had to go film the woman, I would have asked those questions. But see, for me, I wouldn't film that woman because I don't care about you like that. I'm just saying, Umar, you scared that your bag gonna dry up. And you more concerned about this situation with that female at that mall than you are with that dog on school. If you took that much energy that you putting into this situation because you scared your bag gonna get cut off, if you put that much energy opening that doggone school, that black folks gave you, what, $1 million, $2 million? $10 after more than 10 years. Because I remember, Umar, when you started telling people about this school, and black folks gave you money for that school. They gave you off the rip $250,000. And matter of fact, I know he got $250,000 because I did a video back in 2015 saying that he was the right plan that he had, but he was the wrong man. And I showed him why. In a video. And that was $250,000. He's gotten way more money since then for this school that has not opened. You have the global pandemic happen when every school in America was closed. And they went virtual. They went to Zoom and doing class. You did not open up a virtual academy at least during the pandemic. Umar, if you were smart, brother, you would have did that, and black folk would have got off your back. Because black folks' expectations is so low sometimes. Black people have this mindset, well, at least he did this. They don't really have the highest expectation of you opening up that school and talking about it. They hope you open it, but they're not really going to bump up about it. They know this.